Hello everyone, it's Chuck Thunder, and here we are playing a new game. We're playing 7 Days to Die, and it's just a fun one. Figured a nice change of pace, play something different, get a little bit of action in rather than some sailing in, one of my other favorite games. But let's give this a shot, see how this you guys like this, and see if we have some fun in there during this Let's Play. So we're going to start with pretty much everything on default, with the exception of persistent profiles. When I die, I don't want to drop everything. Let's just drop everything in the backpack, but what's in my inventory on my tool belt. I'm marking airdrops so we all know where we're going. And no players killing players, obviously. That would be pointless. No one's going to join me in this game. But alright, so we're going to play on this game world. Oh, let's see, please, pre-gens. No, just do the game world. Alright, let's get this started. So, one of the most important things, I already tried to do a Let's Play with this already, and it didn't have a good start, so let's try to have a better start this time around. I did a Let's Play, recorded it, and died the first day. Not that this game is incredibly hard early on, I just made a lot of mistakes, and it didn't make for a very good first episode of the Let's Play, so let's see if we do a better job this time around. One of my goals, besides to do all the projects that you have to do to get initial questing done, I want to find some form of honey or antibiotic. That's something that if you do not have right away and you get attacked and you get infected, you have a short clock before you die. Which sometimes it's better to just die early on, let it kill you, than spending all the time, you know, gaining experience and then surviving, or not surviving and then dying, because then you'll lose all that earned experience. So it doesn't hurt to start this game smarter than the last time I ran through it. Building the environment, and we're in. Alright, here we are. We are ready to get started. Alright, E to open things, see what we can find. Really what we need to start, anytime we find a rock, pick it up. Let me collect some plant fibers. I'm also going to pick up some cotton and some other things while I'm at it. I don't know if I'm going to need this much, but that's a good start. Tab to open up our crafting menu. Click what it is we want. Craft it. Let's continue to collect some good stuff. Okay, craft our bedroll, put it in the inventory, place it, let's pick it back up. I need to get another stone, and this is why I say I hate the beginning sometimes, because finding a second stone, there's a whole bunch right here, can be sometimes pretty difficult. After a stone axe, now everything else will be easier. I'm gonna make cloth as soon as possible, too, because I want to make some better stuff. Crafter plant fiber shirt and pants. Gather some wood. Craft a wooden club, which isn't my favorite defense weapon, so I'm going to go ahead and scrap that immediately. Get more wood. I need to get a feather. In order to get a feather, we need to find a... We need to find a bird's nest on the ground somewhere. Which normally isn't that hard. But I found one of these, which has a chance of having honey in it, so I'm gonna go and see if there's any in it. There we go. Wow, three of them in a row. That you don't see very often. Another one right here. Jeez. Alright, plenty to go. So let's create our bow. Great defense weapon to start. Something to get some rock from. I believe I saw a stone back here. There we go. It's one of those things I need for a handful of reasons, but mostly because I need arrows. There. Let's see where that puts us. Okay. Okay. Craft a wood frame block. Got our wood frame block. Place it and upgrade it. Alright, we have now finished the introductory portion of the game. Now we gotta build a campfire. Sorry, I thought we were done with the introductory portion of the game. Haven't. That. Now we're gonna find the traitor. A good distance away, so let's get moving. I'm also gonna go ahead and make a spear. One of my favorite early weapons to have. Stones along the way, checking our trash, seeing what we find. Finding wood is not a bad idea. Keeping an eye out on zombies. Don't hear anybody. Ooh. 50% better sneak at night. Shit. Whenever you find those books, learn them up. So we can get a bunch of this stuff. I want some goldenrod. Goldenrod is good for making tea, so is the chrysanthemum. Once we get the recipe. Goldenrod's a little harder to come by. guess that was enough to scare him away. I don't know how I didn't see that dog earlier. Have your wits about you, people. Dog doesn't seem to be coming back. Well, there he comes. Kind of want him dead, though. I'm a terrible shot, aren't I? Well. Alright. Okay. That's what we need to get as much meat as we can off of this. We have food, everybody. Don't get scared. All right. Survive the dog attack. Ooh, bring a chef mod, sure. Parakeets are good. Got our first zombie killed. Usually I go out of my way to kill some zombies, but being that I don't want to get an infection this early on, I'm going to try to avoid most of them, especially a big dude like that right now. love Spider-Man. That's one of the best things. Alright. So, we're all about halfway there. Gotta watch my stamina in this game. Do not want to run out of stamina. Stamina, you gotta wait. That's no bueno. Hoping to find some honey. Yes, we got some honey. And here we are, we found the settlement, the trader. Okay. First thing I like to do when I go to the first time I go to a trader is I like to see what sort of items are lying around in his little basement area here. And here, what sounds like to be zombies running around up top, but nothing I could do about that. Sounds like they're trying to break in.
Something bothering you?
What do you got for me? Anything that I want? Good stuff, but nothing that I need to have right this minute. Don't have the money for half of that. Nope, nothing in particular I need.
I knew you didn't have money the moment I laid eyes on you.
I might need a cooking pot. They got that. All right.
Quit wasting my time.
Thank you. checking all the things. It's going to be very full in here. Our inventory is going to be pretty full. Pumpkin seeds, interesting. Okay. Now I would go into one of these bigger houses, but I'm not entirely sure that I have the ability at this moment to go into the bigger houses and protect myself. So in the meantime, I think I may just have to leave some things in a barrel so I'm not over encumbered. Because, you know, that's important. Those guys gave me a hard time. A really hard time. Let's see what's in here. Thank you. Good start. Sounds like there's more than one. That is what we call a headshot. Probably where I start looking for some extra clothing and start storing. This will probably be my house to start the early nights. Okay, so we're going to start right here. So inside this one, we're going to put all of our metals. And other materials. And here will be food. This. There we go. Okay. Let's get some more arrows made. Needing a lot of stone. One of the earliest resources we need. I need to make our campfire again so we can start boiling up some water. Best ways to get stone very quickly. Let's right through one of these guys. And get some wood from the pallets too, which is kind of nice. Oh, floating rocks. I need it to make some duct tape. Yeah, this is scary. Things get a little sketchy at night, that's for sure. Get really scared sometimes, guys. They get angry sounding. I don't like not having good weapons either, and that's part of the problem. One shot at him. I do this to protect all of the light sources in here, so at least they'll hopefully not let them get out. Light can attract the zombies.
Just to let you folks know, the Trader Joel's will be closing soon.
Suppose that'll do. Hopefully that tops us off. Nighttime. Don't go outside. Oh, I forgot to put down my bedroll. That's kind of important. Maybe I'll make a couple of these, give myself some extra storage. Storage pocket bud, which I can't put on any of my clothing I just thought of. Apparently I could sew a pocket rod on my shirt, which I will take, I guess. So now we have some stuff, skills to spend. So let's go to our skills. Now, so some of the most important skills are some of the treasure hunting skills. No. Lucky looter. That's not bad. Javelin's always good if looking more damage. I think I might go with this one. I might just go in general with a few of these. Just so, because that Javelin Master helps so much. I get more headshot bonus, dismembering chance with spears, rifles, explosive weapons, and tools. Javelin Master inflict craft quality 3 fair spears. Spears now inflict 20% more damage, so let's go ahead and scrap this one. Let's make a new spear. Cook any of this yet without a grill. Space out a little bit. Not the best of my time, most of my time, but take it. also break these cardboard boxes behind it. Not that there's much to get from it. That's the majority of what I needed to clean up. I could chop all this down just to get some more wood, but I don't think that's as important. Alright, now we just kind of wait it out. So everybody, that's the first night. Thank you for watching. We'll resume when it's daylight. The first episode down of this Let's Play. Sorry I wasn't so talkative. I was just scared beyond belief. And I hear another zombie out there. I'm getting a sneak mode. Alright, everybody. Good night.